Hi friends, welcome to Java Coding Skill. In this video, we're going to talk about difference between frontend and backend. What exactly the frontend and what exactly the backend is. If you notice this diagram, right? Here users are able to see the frontend but not backend. Similar to that, in technology also, in the web world also, users are able to see the frontend but not able to backend. What exactly the mean of this? Let us try to understand with this diagram. If you notice that if you open any of the browser or in mobile, also you can use the browser, right? So before discussing this, let us understand one more terminology in order to understand this. This backend and frontend widely used in web technology. If you are using something over the internet, then only we can say frontend and backend terminology. Now coming to the topic, frontend means whatever the thing you are able to see on the screen. The screen might be your laptop or computer or any browser or a mobile device or tablet or any device where you have one screen. On that screen, you can access some internet application or web application where you are able to see something in form of image, in form of input field, in form of any HTML control like radio button, checkbox, or video, audio, hyperlinks, any information. That information which you are able to feel and you are able to see on the screen called frontend. In this example, if you hit google.com in the browser, you are getting a couple of things here. You are able to see some menu item top of the page. You are able to see one Google logo followed by search box, right? Here two buttons, Google search and this, and couple of hyperlink given language. Which language you want to choose. And some footer, common information like footer. I'm from India, so my country name is appearing here. Information could be anything. I'm opening Google here, so I'm getting like this. If you are open Amazon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, based on their application, some UI you are going to get. Or you are having your own product or somewhere you are working, that organization might provide some different application or portal like banking. If you are logging your net banking, you are getting some information. Application can be anything. The thing here, we have to understand what is frontend and backend. So you got some idea about frontend. So here, not only you are able to see, suppose something you want to save. So you will get some form and you can fill that form. Let's take you are going to create one account on Gmail. They're asking first name, last name, and little more information. You are entering those information, click on save button, so your information saved somewhere. So those action also you can take, right? So communicating to the server, this medium called frontend, where you are not only to see the information, even you can send the information. And later you get back that those information. So these concept and these appearance called frontend. I hope you got the frontend part idea. So here I'm using browser. Here left right side is the mobile. Source could be anything. So now coming to backend. You're hitting google.com, you're getting this. So from where this information coming? Somewhere it's stored, right? It might be stored in form of one file. Suppose this, if you notice that if you open Amazon, you will get a lot of images here in form of boxes, right? Some promotion and other information, right? Some product information. If you search any product, those product related information you are seeing. So those information is stored in form of image. So information can be any medium, it might audio, video, image, text, any data. So those stored in the form of file, audio, video, or in database. So all this data coming from the target system, that system called backend. It could be anything, file system where all the images and other information is stored. If you are getting some of the website always providing the same data called static website, I will create one altogether different video on that topic. What is static and what is dynamic website? Few of the website just for information purpose. Anytime you will open, getting same information. So those information written in HTML file as a hard coded manner. That's what every time you're getting the same response. So that is also called backend. Means that file resides somewhere else. That called backend. Some of the data is dynamic in nature. Every time change. So based on condition. If you post some comment on Facebook, someone reply on that, someone more reply on that. So you will get more dynamic data. So those data keep storing somewhere else in the database. So the target system could be file. Data might be available in the form of file. This file may be image. This file may be image, maybe audio, maybe video. Maybe text data. So these things stored in file system, the data stored in the database. Some other source also there that might be too much technical here. Some messaging system is called JMS servers and all, and maybe other messaging system in Java messaging services. So I'm not talking about that. So my intention is just tell you the information which is stored somewhere else, that somewhere else called backend. That backend user not able to see. User only able to see what all the information appearing on the screen or the mobile display or anywhere. So I hope you got idea about frontend and backend. So we will talk more and more about this kind of terminology, like difference between UI developer and backend developer, who developed this front end, who developed that backend, how they are developing, what are the technology involved to develop this front end, what are the technology involved to develop backend, how many ways you can achieve that, what are the language required for that, all those stuff we will talk in more depth in upcoming video. So please be with us. Don't miss any video if you are really interested to understand all this terminology. Thanks for watching the video. Please like and subscribe the channels and press the bell icon to not miss any future notifications.